special thanks to Motion Array for sponsoring today's video. In this video, I'm gonna show you 5 ways that you can speed up your video editing inside Premiere Pro. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
The first way that you can speed up your workflow inside Premiere Pro is to use project templates. For example, here I have a project open that is untitled, but as you can see, I imported all the assets that I would typically use inside my video editing project. For example, I imported my sound effects library, my music, all my graphics that I would use in my tutorials, and I even created a sequence already with labeled tracks and effects applied to them. And if you're in the latest version of Premiere Pro 2024, you can save templates. So if you navigate to File, Save as Template, you can name your new template. So I'm going to name it New Video Tutorial Template, and then you can click Save. Now that we have that, we can close out this project. And for example, if we go into New Project, what you can do is navigate next to Project Template and click on the dropdown. You can see that we have that new template we just created. We can click on that and it will use that project as the template for our new project here. So in this case, I can name this the tutorial or the video that I'm making and choose where to save it. And that saves time rather than trying to import all your assets every time you create a new video. Now, another way that you can speed up your workflow is by using presets and templates. And for this, I like to use Motion Array. Motion Array is a marketplace with tons of video assets like video templates, stock footage, photos, music, and sound effects. And the best part about Motion Array is they even have free assets on the website. So you can create a free account and download free assets, free stock footage, music, sound effects directly from the website. So for example, I like to use a lot of the Mogurts for Motion Array. So if we go into the video templates section, we can navigate to Mogurt. If you scroll down to the bottom left-hand side of the screen, you'll notice this free assets button. When you click on it, only free assets will display inside the window. You can see that each asset is labeled free. You can download these free assets to use in your project. So for example, if I wanted this one, I can click the download button. And then back inside Premiere Pro, I can switch my workspace to captions and graphics. This will display the essential graphics panel. I can click this plus button at the top right corner and navigate to my folder that I just downloaded. I can click choose, and this will auto-populate in here. With that selected, it'll display those Mogurts that you just downloaded. So for example, I can click and drag this out into my timeline to add the Mogurt. I can click play to preview it. We can easily just click on it, and we can easily change out the text and the colors to match the branding. Motion Array also has over 50 new plugins that you can use directly inside Premiere Pro and a lot of different video editing softwares. So for example, I have this clip in my timeline here, and I want to maybe add some color correction, add a nice color grade to it. And a good way to speed up your editing in Premiere Pro when you're applying effects to several clips is to use adjustment layers. So to create an adjustment layer, we can navigate to our project panel and create a new adjustment layer by navigating to the new item button and going to adjustment layer. Just make sure your sequence settings are correct and click OK. And you can click and drag this over your video clips and then just make it the length and duration of all your clips on your timeline here. Now, if you navigate to the effects panel, you can scroll down under video effects. And Motion Array comes with a lot of different presets that you can add to your video clips, or in this case, the adjustment layer. Let's first add a sharpen effect to just sharpen my footage a little bit. We can also add some color correction. So if we scroll down under color correction, there is this one effect I like to use called Exposure Pro. We'll click and drag that on. This displays some color correction options so we can change the exposure, the contrast. We can even choose from a preset. Maybe we want it a little bit warmer. We can boost the contrast a little bit. What's nice is they even have this midtones selector so we can boost or lower the midtones, which you can't easily do inside Lumetri Color. So that's a nice feature to have. And then for color grading, they have this nice effect called Cine Style. We'll click and drag this to our video clip. You can see it just adds a nice cinematic look to our footage. Now you do have a lot of different options you can choose from to adjust the style. So I'm gonna choose one of the presets here and then just make some fine-tune adjustments. You can even turn off the letterbox if you don't want letterbox. I know some people don't like letterbox, or the grain as well if you don't want to introduce grain. But as you can see, the before and after, with just a few clicks, we can use the Motion Array presets to really spice up our footage and give it a nice cinematic look. And by using adjustment layers, this adjustment layer is over all of our clips. That way we don't have to add all these effects to each individual clip in our timeline. Now, another way you can speed up your video editing is just to learn your basic keyboard shortcuts. I'm gonna go over the most common ones I use all the time as a video editor. So the first ones is the JKL shortcuts. When you're inside your timeline and you click L on your keyboard, this will go forward in time. So this basically plays back your footage. And if you double click on it, you notice it goes faster. So you're essentially fast forwarding. And when you click K, you're stopping. And when you click J, you're going backwards. And when you double click on J, you're fast forwarding backwards. Some other keyboard shortcuts I like to use are Q and W. So Q trims what's in front of the playhead. So all of this at the beginning would get trimmed if we click Q on our keyboard. And same thing, W trims anything after the playhead. So we'll click W and you can see we just trimmed off the end. I'm gonna undo that. Another keyboard shortcut I like to use is Command K. That makes a cut on the timeline. So if you hit Command K, that'll make a cut on the video clip. In addition to that, I just recommend knowing all the different keyboard shortcuts for your tools. And if you want to learn more about the tools, I did go over each individual tool. I will link that card in the top right corner. But for example, C for Razor Tool, A for Track Select Forward Tool. Track Select Forward Tool is a really handy tool. This essentially selects everything in front of your playhead, which can be very helpful for selecting certain clips. But get familiar with your keyboard shortcuts. Another thing you might often do as a video editor is delete the gaps in between your video clips. Now there's an easy way to do this inside Premiere Pro that saves some time. So for example, here I have these video clips and I want to delete the spaces in between them. So essentially, you know, clicking and dragging and making these put together and deleting the spaces. But to do this, what you can do instead of clicking and dragging each clip together, you can click the space in between them and click delete. This will automatically delete the gap in between the clips. And say if you have a bunch of clips like this and you want to do all of them in your sequence, what you can do is go up to Sequence, Close Gap. And this will close the gap in between all the clips in your timeline. Now another way you can automatically ripple delete your sequence is by cutting out all the pauses or breaks inside your dialogue clips. So for example here, I'm gonna switch over to my text-based editing workspace. And first I'm gonna transcribe my sequence. So I'm gonna click this transcribe button at the top right corner of the text panel. So once it's done, you'll notice the transcript load up here. And what you can do is click on this filter button and go to pauses. This will select all the pauses. And what you can do is easily click delete and then click delete all. And as you can see, it ripple deleted all the pauses. So this is another quick way to speed up your editing workflow and save some time. If you wanna learn some more ways to level up your video editing inside Premiere Pro, I do recommend checking out this video right up there. But that does it for this video. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments section below. But otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you guys next time.